Thank you, Mr. President. I seek leave to make a brief explanation before addressing a question to the Attorney-General on the topic of the Adelaide Beach Management Review.
Is leave granted? Leave is granted.
In April 2022, the Malinauskas government announced that the planned construction of a sand recycling pipeline between West Beach and Semaphore South would be halted. Instead, a comprehensive review of all available coastal sand management options is being initiated by the Department for Environment and Water to, quote, ensure a long-term solution is found, which puts community and the environment at the core. The review being undertaken by Community Engagement Specialists URPS and Coastal Engineering Specialists Blue Coast Consulting Engineers will include consideration of how to manage sand on Adelaide's beaches to achieve the following two goals: minimise disruption for all communities and avoid environmental harm. However, it's been brought to my attention that there has been a failure of the department to adequately engage local communities. Local Port Adelaide Infill Councillor Peter McGregor has noted, and I quote him, the engagement mail out was to only those residents from Esplanade to Military Road, those living on the first block off the foreshore. Those living east of Military Road will not be notified, and must read about it in the advertiser. Community members have also complained about the contents of the story, with many saying it's so heavily loaded it's not a survey at all. The assumption is the pipeline will go ahead and the public will only have a say in the disruptive fluff around it. End quote. I attended a full meeting in the local cinema where many of these complaints were also aired, and I have heard from dozens of community that they have found this survey impossible to put their views forward to because it only gives them a limited range of options. Our beaches support a much wider community than those that just live on the first block on the foreshore. It is a concern that they have not been adequately informed. My questions to the Minister are, why have residents on the western side of Military Road, on the eastern side of Military Road and further east, been consulted directly and received information to participate in this process? And if they haven't, how can the department justify that limited notification? Also, what will the minister undertake to ensure that views of residents completing the survey or community completing the survey reflect their inability to actually only be given three options to choose rather than provide more direct information from their personal experience?
Call the Attorney General.
I thank the honourable member for her questions, her interest in this area, and obviously as attending forums, the honourable member has heard direct from the public and is putting forward in this chamber concerns that constituents have put to her, and so we do take those very seriously. As I've mentioned before in this chamber, sir, there is an independent review of Adelaide Beach management underway. That was a commitment from this government before coming to government. The review's being overseen by an independent advisory panel and not by the government directly. And I've respected the independence, which I think is appropriate. I haven't sought to insert myself in terms of how surveys or questions or forums are run. I think that's better left to the experts rather than to politicians to do that. I will pass on the concerns the honourable member has raised to that the independent advisory panel that's overseeing the review. Firstly, the question the honourable member had about the breadth of consultation. Yeah, I am aware in all of these sorts of things, wherever you consult to, there will be someone on the other side of a road or in the next suburb who isn't included in whatever level of consultation is decided for, wherever the boundary is drawn, and that is always a necessary feature of any sort of consultation that's done. That, yeah, there will be some people who, if there's a boundary, whether it's a road or a suburb, or on one side or another of those, I accept that as a limitation. Otherwise, on every issue, you'd be consulting every single South Australian. But in relation to, I will put that concern directly to the independent review panel about. I think the honourable member has said Military Road was a boundary of where a particular form of consultation occurred, and I don't know, but I suspect it was. Where residents were contacted directly to ask views or information, whereas those I suspect that fall over the other side of the road weren't precluded from putting views forward but may not have had the same level of contact as on the other side of that boundary being the road. I'll also put forward the concerns that the honourable members raised in relation to how questions in a survey are written. My understanding is, and I will check this and if it, bring back further information if I need to, there was a survey and I said, as I said, sir, I haven't sought to have any involvement in how a survey is worded. I think that's best left to the independent review and the independent advisory panel overseeing the review. But my understanding is I think there were 9 questions, at least the last one, which had an ability for participants to the survey to put any of their views forward that wasn't a tick-a-box question. I have had representations recently about one of the questions. I can't remember what number question it was that, if I'm remembering correctly, basically asked, do you think there should be the level of intervention in the management of sandbar beaches at the current level? Do you think there should be more intervention or less intervention? And it was a choice of those 3. I don't know if that's the same question the honourable members had people expressing concern about, but I certainly will put that to the independent review panel. But my understanding is there certainly is an opportunity as part of that survey to put forward any other matters that either weren't included in a question or were different from a question asked. So I think the honourable member for a question, I can assure her I will put the 2 particular issues she's raised in front of the independent review panel.